we are going to learn about Scala programming language. Scala is a programming language which is derived from two languages. One language is Java, another language is Lisp. These are two languages from which the Scala is derived. Scala is developed. So Scala is not a original language which has developed newly. No, it has been inherited from two already existing languages called as Java and Lisp. Scala is object-oriented programming as well as functional programming language. Okay, remember this point. Okay, Scala object-oriented programming language. So it has both paradigms. Object-oriented paradigm as well as functional program paradigm. Okay, remember these two. So to work with Scala language, what is that required in our systems? What is that required? Where we can install Scala? Okay, so Scala is derived from Java language. What type of Java is? Object-oriented programming. What is the basic feature of most important feature of Java programming language? Java is a platform independent language. Java is a platform independent language. Similarly, Scala also. Why? Because Scala is built by using Java only, isn't it? So platform independent language. Scala also platform independent language. It can be used on Windows, it can be used on Linux, it can be used on Mac OS, Macintosh operating system, on all the operating system this Scala programming, Scala language is going to work. We can work one way. But to install Scala, compulsory Java installation is mandatory. Remember this, Java is mandatory. Without Java, Scala is not going to get installed, is not going to work at all. Remember this point. Java is mandatory to run Scala applications or to work with Scala. Is it clear? So Java is a hybrid language which is based on purely most of the Scala programming is based on Java. There is object-oriented programming and functional programming. And what is the language called as functional programming? From which functional programming Scala has taken its roots? Lisp, L-I-S-P. Lisp is the functional programming language from which Scala has taken its roots. Okay, and but working with Scala, it requires Java. Java is mandatory. And as Java is platform independent, Scala is also platform independent. Got it? Now let us try to start learning about object-oriented programming. You can simply see that what type of programming is object-oriented programming. Yeah, what is this object-oriented programming? So the term itself saying that object-oriented, that is everything in this programming we are going to use objects. We use objects. Okay, so what is an object and how it is based, how it is object-oriented, why we are calling it as object-oriented, what is an object? Okay, let's try to do that. Okay, now why we are writing these programs? What do we do with programs? Yeah, try to answer here. What is that we do with the program? Just now I have said, what is a program? Set of statements, isn't right? Just now I said that set of statements. As a paragraph is a set of sentences, a program is a set of statements. So what does a statement call as? I write some x equal to 20, x plus y, z equal to x plus y. Some y is equal to a plus b, something a plus b minus c. I write some operations. Okay, so we're assigning some value to x, some 22x, 42y, and we're some computation. Computation in the sense set of operations. Do you agree with this? Some set of operations is called as a this is one computation. So I call the same set of operations. So we are here, we are performing addition operation, we are performing addition, subtraction, likewise this assignment operation, likewise we perform different types of operations, some set of operations. So to perform an operation, if you want to perform x addition operation between addition operation, what is that required? What are x and y here? We require two. Suppose if you perform 2 plus 3, simply I write plus. Do we have any meaning for simply if I write plus? Is there any meaning for it? This is called as addition operator. This is called as operator or operation. But if I do not provide the data to this, is it going to do anything? Is it going to do anything? If I don't provide any data to it, is it going to do anything? No. So we have to, you know, set of operations in the sense we have to provide the operator as well as the data to be operated, data on which the operation to be performed, isn't it? So we need to provide a program in nothing but set of statement. What is a statement? A statement is the proper construction. A statement is a proper construction of operators and operands. Operands in the sense the data. What are the data we call it as? We call it as data. Operators and operands. Got it? No. Operators and operands is required for performing any what you call as operation, that is computation or the operation. Okay. These operands are this data. This data is going to be stored as an object. The data will be stored as an object in object-oriented programming languages. The data is stored as an object only. If you store some data, that data is stored as an object only. Remember that. Okay. So such programming languages will be called as object-oriented programming languages, where the data is stored or the data is represented, whatever you think. If you want to use data, if you want to declare data, if you want to save data, whatever it may be, that must be done with the help of an object only. That's it. So this is the reason why this language is called as object oriented programming language. Everything, you know, if you have data, you know, everything revolves around our data only. So the data is going to be represented by an object. That's the reason why we call it as an object oriented programming language. So where to write these programs? I want to write a Java program, I want to write a Scala, I want to write some Python program. Where are you going to write these programs? We have to write, we can choose an either RDE or a text editor. We can use an IDE or we can use a text editor. We can use a notepad, we can write an exam, no, program a notepad, we can save it as dots, as a save the program, and we can, or we can write in an IDE. After writing a program, we compile it, we run it. After writing a program, this is called as a source code. This is also called as source code. And after writing the program, this must be compiled. And compiled program must be again executed. This is called as run or execute. Okay, program, run and execute. So after writing a Scala program, we need to save that program as .scala with extension .scala. Got it? Okay. Now in this session, I'm trying to show you the Scala program in a text editor. So let me use one text document here. Let me call it as Scala 1 dot Scala. It must be saved with dot Scala extension. Okay, I'm using Scala 1 dot Scala here. Open it and write a program here. Object. I write demo 1. Demo program. This I'm writing demo program object, and def main main args colon. Don't get panic here. It seems to you, if you are new to the programming life, it seems to be a bit confusing. Everything will understand very clearly. The beginning session you may get some confusion, but don't get panic. Okay, and here right here println. Welcome to Scala world. That's it. Close the method and close the file. That's it. Save this file. Saved with dot Scala extension. Okay. Now close this file. Save as. Just go to command prompt. CMD. Command prompt. And I'm telling you, Scala must be already installed. Okay, after installing Scala only. Okay, the Scala installation is very simple. Where do we have that file? We have that file on the desktop, isn't it? On the desktop, we have that file. So let's get to desktop. CD desktop. So if you see the file, I'm using Windows environment. Okay, we have this file called as Scala 1 dot Scala. I think .txt must be removed from here, it must be used with dot Scala. One second, let me open this. नोटपैड फाइल सेव एज स्काला वन ओके ओके लेट दिस ट्राई लेट अस ट्राई इट वर्क्स आर नॉट लेटर विल ट्राई टू सी दैट नाउ टू कंपाइल दैट प्रोग्राम यूज स्काला सी Scala C dot Scala 1 dot Scala actually it must not be dot Scala. Let us see what happens with this. Actually the file must end with dot Scala extension. I think it worked. Let us see. Yeah, worked with this now. So what is the file? This is the file. This is the program file. And something is generated on the desktop. You can see here. Demo.class and demo.class. This is a demo.class. Where do we have this demo here? In the program, we have demo here. Okay. So with this, what did we do with this? Yes, can you tell me what did we do with this? With this, we are compiled that program. We have compiled it. The command scala c is the command that is used for compile this. I told you, first we have to write a program. After writing the program, we have to compile it, isn't it? We have to compile it. After compilation is done, we have to execute it. So we have written some sample program here. I have compiled that program. So I moved it to desktop and I have compiled this program by using the scala c space the file name, isn't it? After if the compilation is done successfully, it doesn't show anything. If there are any errors, it will throw an error. It will throw an error. Okay. So if it is successfully compiled, a file will be created. You know, a file will be created with extension dot class on this name, demo dot class. You can observe here, demo dot class is created. So if the demo dot class successfully created, assume that just simply understand that. The program has got compiled successfully. Got it now? Now, after compilation is done, how to run this program? This is very simple. Scala space demo. What is the name of the class here? What is the class file created here? Demo.class. So use demo here. That is Scala and demo. This is how we have to run it. Now, can you see the output here? Welcome to Scala world. That is what we have written in this program. Got it now? So writing a program, compiling it and running it. It's very simple. So write this program like this and compile it by using this. Scala C is used for compilation and Scala and followed by class name. Remember class name. Scala C file name. Okay, in which we have the program and Scala class name. That is dot class. For which the name of after which we have dot class extension, use that for execution. Clear? If you want to write a program, we can write the program, but to run that program, we require data. We require data. So how this data is going to be stored in memory? Okay, this data is going to be stored as just now I told you why we call it as object-oriented programming language. Why? Because data is represented as an data is stored as an object. Data is stored as object in the form of objects. Data is stored in the form of objects in this Scala programming language as objects. Okay, data as objects. So if we have some data, that data will be stored as an object internally, and there must be some reference to fetch the data out of this object. There must be some reference. This is somewhere in memory. In memory RAM. This is the RAM memory. So the data is stored in the form of an object. And we have to use one reference. We cannot use directly the location where the object is stored. We cannot remember the memory address. It is not possible. Instead, will have an alias name to that address that we call as a reference. Reference referring to the data that is stored in memory. Fine. Okay. This variable, this reference, we call it as similarly what variables. We call it as a variable. remember that. Okay, so when we say while, here we use, here in the Scala programming language we use two keywords. One is called while, another is called as where. While and where, and x and y, these are the variables. We write like this, right? 20 and 30. This is what we have written, something like this now. 20 and 30. So x is a variable, y is a variable. So I say that x is the reference and y is also one more reference. So if I write these two statements, what will happen in memory? Two objects will be created, object 1 and let us say object 2. So the first object is going to store 20, second object is going to store 30, and this will be referred by x, this object, and this object will be referred by y here. Okay, so x equal to 20, y equal to 20. So we'll discuss what is val here later. Just not focus on this, just understand x equal 20, y equal 20. So what is 20 and what is the x? Is a variable, y is a variable. So we also call it as what? Reference. We can call x and y as, so in this we can call x and y as variables or references, or references, variables are references. And what is this 20 and 30? So with this 20 and 30, objects will be created in, I'm telling you the 20 and 30 is data, right? This is data. 20 is some data and 30 is one more value, some data. So the internally objects are going to be created, and those objects, the data will be stored into those objects, in the stored in the form of objects, and those objects are being referred by x and y here. Is it clear? X and y, what is that happening? So if you want to use some data, if you want to use some data, that data will be stored as an object internally in memory. Remember that point. So to store the data, to create object, what do we use? To create a variable, use always two keywords. Either we can use keyword well and we can use the keyword where. Remember that. Okay, is it clear? Fine. So here x storing integer, y is storing an integer value, okay, and printing x and y, and we create a variable either by using the keyword val, either by using the keyword var. Remember that we create a variable in Scala programming language. I'm telling you a variable or a reference. So here x and y are called as the references or variables. We create them by using two keywords, either val or by using var. So there is a difference in creation of a variable by using val and by using var. We will understand, we'll try to understand that difference in the coming up sessions. Now here, what is this demo 3 and what is this main, what is this x and y? Just let me write this here. Let me write those. Here, demo 3 is a class. Demo 3 is a class. Main is a method. Main is a method. Demo 3 is a class and main is a method. Okay, and a comma x comma y are references, or references are variables. References are variables. A comma x and y are variables, and unit is result type, and println is a method. Got it? And what are all the keywords here? So object, def, val and val, these are nothing but what? Keywords. Combination of all this is going to make a simple program, Scala program. Got it?